Tonight, a special report from News 8's Meredith Jorgensen. She's away from work fighting a rare form of uterine cancer. She's sharing her own story to help others understand what it means to live with cancer. For most patients, chemotherapy is a part of treatment. Well, tonight she shows us how doctors and nurses make chemotherapy as comfortable as possible.
When faced with the diagnosis of cancer, many patients have the same fear.
You look at a woman and the first thing she just is thinking is, how long do I have, or don't let me die. And so anything that you can give them in their journey is going to be something that they wouldn't have had without you.
Dr. Jacqueline Evans aims to make the journey as comfortable as possible. Most of her patients receive hours of chemotherapy infusions. They do that here in the chemo lounge.
If I were the patient, if I were on the receiving end of this news of having to come in with fear every single time you're coming in, you want something bright, something homey. But I went to Lazy Boy and I said, I want the most comfortable chairs. I'm going to give chemotherapy in these.
And comfortable they are. Each week I wear sweatpants, pull up a blanket, and dig in for hours. While fighting cancer is daunting, the prospect of simply sitting and even relaxing or reflecting is a welcome change of pace for me.
Other times, like everyone, it's like a big party because everyone just sits back here and chats away.
It can be a room full of energy, and the IV pole is the only thing that keeps me tied down.
Yeah, you need to come out of your shell a little more, Meredith.
Let's just say I've made chemo friends, like Agnes Pearsall.
We're all in this together.
And many cancer patients feel the same, a sense of kinship only those experiencing treatments can understand. It seems there really is strength in numbers.
It's a small room. I mean, all of the patients are in the same boat. And I think patients like, you know, to share their stories with each other.
I know these girls in here can relate to what I'm going through.
Being able to relate and knowing you are not alone is something that sustains many cancer patients.
Most people think, you know, cancer, it's such a negative, you know, diagnosis, when it doesn't really have to be.
Even when the going gets tough, there are people here to cheer you on.
Now, many cancer patients say they are touched by the support others offer during their illness. Agnes Pearsall is one of those people who touch Meredith. In her next story, Meredith will share Agnes's 6-year battle with cancer and explain how she is an inspiration for anyone living with the disease.